got the Ultrabook, started to get our next clue. And then from there,
we went to this fish restaurant, which is very hands-on. Day two, Mark gets to choose his partner, and he chose Anusha.
Your followers can help you to win the next challenge. Have them go here.
At 8:15 tonight and follow the balloons.
We need to find this place which has the blue balloons.
My name is Daniel and I live in Jakarta, Indonesia.
Let's go.
My name is Anusha and I live in Mumbai.
Oh, I need to learn how to speak Russian.
My name is Leon Oliveira Martins. I'm from Goiânia, Brazil.
I love Leon. You got a lot of fans.
My name is Mark Watson. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri.
Blue balloons! Blue balloons! Blue balloons! Yes!
We used Google Maps to try to find the place where we were and the place where we were supposed to go.
The boys, Daniel and Leon, reached there first. They both got dressed. They basically had costumes lined up for them. And they chose a costume. And then Daniel took all these costumes that were left there for us and just left two pieces. And he hid the others.
That was good. That was good.
It's cross.
I just got this idea of just, you know, hiding the whole wardrobe and just leave a skirt for Mark. Which I thought was funny at the time, but you know, it was a bad idea.
When we got there, there was only this polka dot skirt left with a really cute hat, and there was this furry hat with this, like, you know, really cute frilly top. So I was like, don't worry, let's do this, you know? So I put on the top, obviously, because that wasn't going to fit Mark. And then I tied the skirt around him. He put his hat on, I put mine. So we have to look up Kalinka dance, it's a Russian form of dance. And we just looked it up on YouTube, so he's got it on his page. It's more like a frog dance.
Me and Leon, we tried to be as stupid as possible, but I think we're not getting love from the Russians with our stupidity.
So I never performed a day in my life on stage, anything like that. But I'll just say, hey, it's gonna get through it, do my best, and I had Anusha right there, and I knew we were just gonna kill it. I think it kind of worked out for the outfit that Daniel left me, that little skirt. I guess it kind of accentuated my moves a little bit, so I think it probably like that.
It made him look stupid, but at the same time, people sympathized with that. And then he had Anusha, who's so good at dancing already. She just moved a little bit of her hips. People were just like stunned. Mark just, you know, he was like the cherry on top of that performance, and obviously they won the challenge.
On the third day, Mark and I had a 5-minute head start.
We had to find a couple statues and take a picture of us in front of them, of a rider and then some type of Russian leader.
Let's check on my Twitter. I got direct message.
Today's challenge is a scavenger hunt across St. Petersburg.
Clues will be tweeted to you, so be sure to check Twitter.
They may have 5 minutes head start, but hey, I got brain.
Let's get moving.
I'm going that direction because that's a park. They probably have a statue there.
I know there's a Russian writer somewhere.
What if we get the picture and ask somebody to translate here? That looks like a Russian writer.
Statue of a Russian writer. I think his name is Dostoevsky or something. Where's Dostoevsky? The statue, Dostoevsky. They just walk away. Why did I think of this? Information! Info! The statue of Dostoevsky. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Here, All right, let's go.
See that statue up there? I think he's holding a book in his hand. I think so. He couldn't be a writer. Hi. No.
Dostoevsky.
Where's that?
It's somewhere near that famous market.
Let's do this. There. That's a writer, right there. I'm gonna open the software to take a picture. You're the guy. You are born in Moscow, you're Russian, so yeah. Good job. Now tweet a picture of you with the statue of a Russian ruler.
That looks like a writer. He's holding a book, but clearly not. So now I have to like move on. I'm gonna be the last to know it.
This guy looks like a Russian writer. I'm gonna get in those people's picture. All right. It looks like Leon went to the same person I went to earlier, and he's got the name right.
Do you know where there's a famous Russian writer anywhere around here?
No, I don't know.
Oh, there's another guy with a pen in his hand. Okay, that has to be him.
The closest statue is Pushkin Monument, and that's in Nevsky Prospect. Yeah, Nevsky Prospect?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Leon and Mark found it. Is this Pushkin? No, I don't think it's Pushkin.
No. Go there.
All the way to St. Petersburg. And I see a mass moonwalking course. We're so lost, man.
Good job. Now tweet a pic of you with a statue of a Russian ruler. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a picture in front of this statue. He may be a ruler. Nobody else has tweeted anything yet, so I think we're still good.
No. That guy. I'm Googling information about the park, and I find out it's the Alexander II, right? So probably there's a statue of Alexander II here. I'm going back to that statue I saw in the beginning. He has military clothing. He's probably a ruler.
Statue of horse? Oh my god, I found the statue! Hello. You look beautiful.
I'm taking a picture of Peter the First. And I'm out of breath. Peter the First, the guy who actually built the city. Enter the metro shop where Intel engineers might go to school. Someone is behind me.
Oh, well, you know. Okay, so Leon wasn't that behind, in front of me. He just left. So I've got the writer, I've got the name in Russian, and I've got myself all in the picture.
I think I'm headed in the right direction. How can I miss this one?
Oh my god! did you just get here?
Yeah, this is your first or second one?
This is the second one!
The writer is in the middle of the park.
This is not the writer?
You look like a writer. Good job. Now enter the metro stop where Intel engineers might go to school.
I could just go to a souvenir shop and take a picture behind me.
Do you have a Pushkin or Dostoevsky statue?
Tweet a pic of you with a statue of Russian writer. Tweet must include the writer's name in Russian and Ultrabook race. Outdoor only. Cool. I got another clue. Good job. Now tweet a pic of you with a statue of a Russian ruler. Tweet must include ruler's name in Russian. Outdoor only. Peter the Great.
Yep.
I think I'm winning. What's the next clue? Bring it on.
We have to ride the subway to find the underground statue of the writer of Eugene Onegin.
Wait, I see a statue. This guy looks more like a writer. I'm trying to get everything in there. I've completed two tasks, and now it says, excellent. Now enter the metro stop where Intel engineers might go to school.
All right, this is the station, I believe. Subway entrance.
I just need to find the subway station now. It's somewhere there.
Okay, next stop.
Okay, that's
thank God.
Let's tweet this.
Okay, I need to go upstairs to upload it.
What a workout!
Right now, I just need to upload the photo to Twitter.
I'm done. Congratulations, you've won today's challenge!
Hey, welcome!
You got first.
What took you so long?
Oh my god, I think that's him!
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Seriously, don't worry.
See you guys!
Go!
Ultrabook, inspired by Intel.